Apalachicola, Florida is often referred to as Florida's forgotten coast, but after my Tripletail trip last year with Captain Mark Butler, it wasn't something I would soon forget. When the chance arrived this summer for a return trip, it didn't take me long to remember the way back to this beautiful historical fishing village. As anyone in the Southeast has noticed, we've hit record high temperatures this summer, but as I've always said, the hotter the better to catch Tripletail. We are once again the guest of Mark and Wendi Butler of Tripletail Charters, who pulled all the stops out to make us feel welcome. Join us as we head out and explore all this port town has to offer in the land of the friendly people, coming up next, right here on Gary Finch Outdoors. Wendi and Mark, thank y'all for having us again. We've been looking forward to it, and last year we had such a great time that we were really excited about coming again. Tell us a little bit about what I'd really like to know is how all this happened. And what I mean all this is Apalachicola.
Well, so many moons ago, I don't want to say early 90s to date myself, Mark was working for a company, and they sent him down here to fix an office issue. And they put him up in an inn in town, and he was here for a week, and he called me and he said, "Oh my gosh, you have to come down, right? This is so amazing. You will just love it here." And the next weekend, Danielle and Mark and I came down and stayed, and we visited the town and everything. And as we drove back to Gulf Breeze, we went through 30A, which was during scallop season. And there were all these cars pulled off the side of the road, and we stopped to ask them, "What are you doing?" And they said, "We're scalloping." And so the next weekend, we came down to go scalloping, and that was it. That was the bug. We started coming and coming and coming, and then all of a sudden we're like, "Holy cow, we should maybe buy a place here." Of course, our place wasn't completely functional. We did a complete fixer-upper, but we just knew that we loved this place, you know, that it was someplace that we were going to come no matter what, so we might as well invest in it. So,
and now we're getting close to retirement age. I think we're just going to retire and stay here full-time.
So that's great. That's our plan. Mark, tell us a little bit about, you know, we're going to go after tarpon in a little bit in early in the mornings. And then, of course, I'm excited to always. You mentioned Tripletail, and I get a little crazy. Tell us the game plan that you're thinking about the next couple of days.
Yeah, we're going to launch probably a half hour before sunrise and launch downtown Appalachia and run out into the bay. And normally the tarpon bites pretty hot right at the first hour of daylight. And we're going to go out there and drag around some baits and try to get a tarpon bite. Wendi and I got a really nice tarpon Wednesday. Yeah, so we'll do that in the morning, and then we'll once the sun gets up a little bit, then we'll start looking for Tripletail until we can't handle the heat anymore.
Tell us a little bit about, you know, how things got started in getting another house.
Well, this was our dear friend Ed's home. Ed Moberly retired down here, and in his retirement, he took up wood carving. And so you can see, like, some of the samples of his art are all through the guidehouse. He did so many different things, and his work, he would donate it to, like, the library or the schools, and they would auction it off to benefit the kids. So he was just amazing. And so with 20 years of being down on weekends and long vacations or whatever, just became part of our family. And he had to move away because of an age issue, and his family sold the house to us.
We put clients up here, family, friends, anybody that comes down, and it works out great. So I'm doing charters, normally do half day charters, and then we'll put them overnight in the house a night or two to stay in the house. So.
And when you say charters, we need to let people know that you're a licensed captain, and
You got all the credentials to go with it.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Mark, tell us a little about the waterways and all the different types of fishing that not only that you provide, but that are available down here.
Yeah, I mean, Apalachicola River's got some amazing bass fishing up here in the spring. I personally don't do a lot of that. I'm usually either out in the bay or out in the Gulf. In the bay, there's redfish, speckled trout, flounder, lots of tripletail. And then if you want to run offshore, within 10 miles, you can get some really nice red snapper here. I've actually gone out that and done that a couple times. We brought our bigger boat down here and did some red snapper trips and had a lot of success.
Looking forward to going fishing, Mark.
We're going to have fun.
We're looking forward to it and just glad to be here. Thank you all again.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
It's a sunrise start in Apalachicola when we return to Gary Finch Outdoors.
We set out just before sunrise from the launch in downtown Apalachicola, heading out in smooth waters, hoping to jump off a few tarpon before we spend the majority of the day running and gunning for tripletail. The beautiful sunrise and the glassy surface told me that this was going to be a tripletail kind of day. As Mark set the baits for tarpon, the view from his bottom machine looked promising, and there was quite a bit of movement near the boat. As Mark's reel began to scream, it was obvious the activity wasn't the kind that we were looking for.
Jumping. Small bird.
Come on, baby, get up.
Go up, go up, go up.
Come on, baby. Uh-oh, shark.
Shark.
Uh-oh, look at her, that's a little
shark. Little baby
shark.
Go,
Shannon.
I'm going to put him on the side of the boat. After three calls for shark, 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 it was time to start our search for tripletail.
Oh, that's the little guy.
Yeah.
Is that the one we saw?
I don't know. I don't think so. I think the other one...
I thought I saw a bigger one.
I think the other one we saw took off.
Huh?
That floating piece of wood. It's going to have a big one on it for me.
There you go. I'm getting bit. I'm getting bit.
Okay.
Double up, Derek.
Double hookup.
First buoy we checked this morning. Double triple tail.
Pretty.
Lower, this one's feels pretty solid. I think this is his twin brother, about the same size.
How about that? Well, that one's a little bit bigger.
Might be dinner. Probably 17. It's been our luck.
A lot of 17-inch fish in that place. Maybe it's 18.
We'll let him go.
Slowly. Gently.
There he goes.
No, not yet.
Are you hung in it?
No. The fish is on the other side. All right,
there
got
you go.
It.
You got him up. Holy cow.
I just keep on going straight.
Let him run away from the buoy.
I am. I'm going to pull him away from the buoy.
Is he a keeper?
I don't know. He's close, but just keep going forward. Keep going forward.
It's not a baby.
right. Good job, Captain Butler. Tell us a little bit about the limits and what they got to be and how, you know, how many you can keep.
They got to be at least 18 inches long. Keep two per person, except for the charter boat captain. This one happens to have a tag in it.
All right.
And it's been in there a while.
Now, so what do you normally do when there's a tag in it, Mark?
We're going to get a picture of the tag number.
Okay.
And then we'll send it to the University of Southern Mississippi, and they'll tell us where it was caught, when it was caught.
Now, don't you agree that a lot of people, when they catch one, the first thing they do is try to pull the tag out?
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you recommend?
I like just taking a picture.
Right.
And then you got it for sure. And then they want the length. That's the only other thing they need, is to know how big he was.
Okay, cool.
What do we got? Then they'll tell you, they'll send you an email and tell you where he was originally caught. He's 15 and a half.
Tag, good fish, very healthy.
Yeah.
Measuring it.
You can see the tag number on there, maybe. And we're gonna let him go.
Good job.
And away he goes.
There he goes.
So he's been caught. All right. He's been caught at least twice now.
Yep, he sure has. I'm trying to bring him to Shannon.
Show him back to, instead of hooking one, don't let him eat it. Try to bring him back to the boat again.
Look, see him, Sam?
There he comes.
There's two of them right there. Isn't that great? Look at that.
He ate. Fish on.
How about that? Okay. Boy, they're explosive, aren't they? How about that? This is the kind of video that's great. I counted six at one time.
I had a feeling today was going to be a good day. Beautiful. Beautiful fish.
They pulled on the mark.
Yes, sir. Oh,
God, Mark. Captain Mark does it again. Well, Captain Mark, as we pulled up here, he said that there could be two or three on this particular pad. And when we pulled up there, I saw two of them come out from under it, and then four more came. So it was either catch one, don't catch one. So we decided to at least catch one and see what size they were. They're all probably 14, 15 inches.
Three tails. There he goes.
That's awesome. Awesome release, too. Fantastic.
That's,
there you go, Captain Mark.
Thank you.
Captain Mark Butler tries a new bait tactic when we return to Gary Finch Outdoors.
Yeah, it is a little bit bigger.
Girth. Oh, strike one.
Wow, isn't that great?
It's a fighter. Oh, that is a big fish. Oh, he might be 18.
Good job, Captain Mark.
Let's see what we got here.
What? You don't decide to book your trip to get the Tripletail, Captain Mark Butler, on Tripletail Charter from Appalachicola. Crazy.
He's legal.
Really?
He's 19.
How about, what?
Yep. He's 18 and a quarter, 18 and a half.
Fantastic, Mark.
He is going home for dinner.
And you can, if you can't tell right now, that if you don't book your trip with Captain Mark Butler of in Appalachicola, with Tripletail Charters, you're absolutely crazy. Mark, you know what? That shrimp is working pretty good, but I can't complain because I know you put the crab on a while ago.
Yeah, we got the last keeper. Last one we threw in the box was caught on a crab, so we like them. The big 2-inch seemed to work the best. Berkeley Gulp. Give me a call. You could sponsor my charter business.
That's right.
We'll have all the information at the end of the stream, Berkeley. So make sure you send Mark, Captain Mark Butler, some of these. And, you know, I've always been crazy about wanting to, you know, gotta have shrimp. But I tell you what, Captain Mark Butler's made a believer out of me. First put on the crab and catch a legal fish. I think they're right in.
Yeah, we're getting them.
Tell you what.
15.
How long?
15.
Wow.
We're going to put a tag on them. Beautiful, 15 inch strip.
Tagged and ready to go.
There he goes.
Gary. All right.
We'll be right back with more Gary Finch Outdoors.
Beautiful Indian Pass in St. George Island. Not a better place to be in the world, right? All right, come on, be a fish here. No, it is a different fish.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Oh, that's a real good one, dude. Oh, nice. That's a keeper, dude. Take your time with him now.
Gotcha.
You got him off the buoy. You're fine. That's a keeper.
I thought it was a different one.
This year, the biggest fish we've got was 22 inches, which is unusual. Typically, we get a couple 27s, and biggest ever was 30. So we're due for a big fish this year. It just hasn't happened yet. It normally happens before now, this late in the season, you know. But so maybe today's the day, Gary.
I'm going to go forward.
Yeah, please.
Oh
man, look at that!
Like a tarpon. Like a blue marlin.
Way to go! I got a horse system.
Yeah, no, take your time. I'm just trying to get him out of the glare.
For sure. Good job.
Going back in the glare.
No, he doesn't.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, that's a good one. Might have took us all morning, but we finally got one.
How about that?
Solid fish.
Good job.
Oof. 20 inches.
How about that? Well, Mark, we've been fishing about, an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours?
Yep, super hot.
Caught a couple of small ones. Caught one you said that was tagged and took a picture of it and got the tag number.
Yep.
Finally, had to have one about 20, 22 inches on. It just took us for a ride. And you said these fish are getting smart and actually wrapped around the buoy a couple times.
Yep, they're doing it a lot this year.
And then we saw the smaller one up on top, and then this one was on the bottom that neither one of us saw.
Yeah.
And we thought it was a small one biting, and then we threw back in there and got this one. Tell us a little about what happened.
Yeah, it was exciting. I mean, after losing the first fish on breaking us off on the buoy line, this one was trying to do it.
Yeah.
And you put the heat to him and got him around the corner, and you know, about half of them go towards the buoy, the other half go away. Once you turned them, he went away. So then we took our time with him.
Yeah, and I noticed one thing that you did when he went away from the buoy, you sort of helped ease me and the fish away from it.
Yeah, I threw it in reverse and just came back slow, you know.
Fantastic. So, I tell you
beautiful
what,
fish.
Heavy fish, too.
Yeah, 19, 20 inches.
That's fantastic.
We'll be eating good tonight.
It's hot. There's no wind.
So hot.
It's triple tail weather.
Yeah, it's what you want, right?
Fantastic.
Look at it.
Well, Mark, it's been a great day. And we're out here under the cleaning station, cleaning a few fish. And you said something about maybe somebody would cook these up for us?
Yes, sir. Scipio Creek, about four blocks from here.
Yeah.
They do a catch and cook little special. And we'll ride down there in the golf cart and have a fantastic, maybe get half of it fried and half of it blackened.
Oh, wow.
So we'll go down there tonight and have a good time.
That sounds good to me. I'll tell you what, there's nothing better than fried fish or blackened fish or any kind of fish, especially when somebody else cooks it.
Exactly.
We don't. You and I do a great job catching it, but yeah, we don't mind anybody else cooking it.
Absolutely not.
That's fantastic, man. I'm really looking forward to it.
After a great day of fishing, we did enjoy our catch fried up perfectly for us by Half Shell Dockside at Scipio Creek. We'd also like to thank John Carlton and Rick Turner for helping us out on the chase boat. If you'd like to book a trip with Captain Mark Butler and Tripletail Charters, you can find him at the information on your screen. That's our show for this week, and we'll see you next week right here on Gary Finch Outdoors.